class we are discussing the error handling in titration. What are the various common error and the mistake which we commonly do in the titration and which we should avoid doing the titration. First is rinsing. What is rinsing? Washing the apparatus with the solution we are taking. Washing the apparatus with which the solution we are taking is called rinsing. We rinse all the apparatus which we use in the titration. Suppose in the period I am taking HCl, I will wash it with HCl. First with water, then with HCl, that is rinsing. But the one apparatus which we never rinse is titration flask. Because in titration flask, we take the measured volume. If we rinse it before, it will add on to the volume and change the reading. Second mistake which we commonly do is, we have to fill the apparatus up to the brim. Mostly students forget to fill it up to the brim. We have to put the beaker under the burette and we have to open the knob so that it will up to the brim and there is no bubble. Suppose bubble is not going, it means it will be the constant error in all the reading, do not worry about that. Third is, when you start the titration, always remove the funnel. See, when I remove the funnel, it will add on 2 to 3 drops of water. So again, it will change the reading if you will remove the funnel immediately. Point number 5 is, this is a burette and we never blow out last drop from the burette. See, always the last drop is there in the burette, never blow it out because excluding that drop it is 10 ml. Last thing is, the liquid always have a curved surface. Every liquid has a curved surface and this curved surface is called meniscus. In case of colored liquid, we leave the upper meniscus because door is not visible. And in case of colored less liquid, we always read the lower meniscus because it is visible. So these are the common errors which you should keep in mind and you should avoid doing these errors. Hope you understand this and be careful about it. Thank you.